Hello, welcome to another Halloween haul video type thingamabob. Don't really know what these type of videos are. Also, do you like my little doodle? I still have a bit of like pen doodles on me from earlier. I need to wipe them off, but I've not yet had a wash. Don't worry, I do have a wash and they will be removed from my skin tablet, even though they're cute. I don't even know what he is. He's just a little plant dude. I saw him on TikTok a couple of days ago and he's been my buddy ever since. Anyway, so speaking of TikTok, actually, that goes on to what this video stemmed from. I follow a lady on TikTok who's like all gothic-y, and she's been doing like a Halloween with me at a certain shop, and so she's done like Halloween with me at Asda. I've already been to Asda, it's rubbish. Halloween with shop with me pound shop, which I've already done, and you may remember from the last video, which was the pound shop Halloween one, I mentioned the cat succulent thing that we couldn't get because we were all chipped. Well, when my mum and my sister dropped me off at Armskirk for my first day of uni last week, they went into pound shop and da-da, he's now on my desk, proud of place near all my pens. So I now have him, and there are no chips and no cracks. So she did one for Sainsbury's, and they had a load of Nightmare Before Christmas stuff. So I showed it my mum, and we were like, oh my god, on a day off, we have to go. So that's what we did. But sadly, they didn't have any of the Nightmare Before Christmas stuff, which was heartbreaking. But they did have, like, there was quite a lot of, like, party games, actually, and a lot of, like, kiddie bags and stuff, and, like, plushies, but I'm not quite sure we can really use party games now. The plushies were really cute, but I already have way too many plushies, which are all up there, and I can't risk getting any more. I already have too many. So yeah, but we did end up getting a few things despite the lack of Nightmare Before Christmas stuff. But we have seen that they're on Amazon as well. So we're not Amazon, on Argos, which is like connected to Sainsbury's. So we'll see. We'll either wait and see if they come into Sainsbury's if we check again, or we'll hopefully order it off Amazon because they were so cool. They were like barbly type things, and also like a hanging decoration just of Jack Skellington. It was amazing, and I really wanted it. Well, and so does my mum, not just me. I'm not just forcing her to purchase stuff. So, on to what we got. So my mum really liked these on the video that I showed her. So when we went, I made sure that she got them. I'm also liking, I think Sainsbury's are doing some sort of like eco thing, because these aren't actually plastic. They're like paper ties instead. I think they have like metal inside still, but like it's just like paper, I think. Definitely not plastic, but the thing themselves are plastic. They're just like wicked witch legs that you can stake in the ground. They're just hollow plastic, but they look sort of cool. And I got a couple of birdhouses a couple of Christmases ago, and I've still got one left that I've not painted. So what I think we're going to do is stick them in the ground, and then I can paint and decorate the birdhouse to look like a house is squishing her, and like put a mini house in front of her and then giant legs behind it. So that's an idea. We'll see how that goes. This one is another one that my mum sort of forced me to get it, to sort of encourage it, because, well, I said for her to get it for herself, but then she kept mentioning about me getting it so I would drink more Capri Suns. But so I'm not sure actually whose it is, whether it's mine or my mum's, but it's still really cute. It is a little like glass tanker thing that has bat tonic written on it. Since 1965, that's the wrong year, Ellie. Since 1654, bat wing tonic, and then it's got like a cute bat decoration. It is like double plastic in on the inside, so you've got like this bit which is the green inside, and then there's like another bit of plastic, can you see it there? So I think it's like a bit of insulation. I'm assuming you can't really put hot drinks in for it to keep it hot, but maybe it's to keep cold drinks cool. So it's just like you just pull the lid off, and then it's like metal-y, I think, and then losing the straw, and then like silicone batwing top and then just a normal plastic straw. I really wish like the straw maybe it would have been like all black or black and green instead of black and white, because it does look a little bit weird. I'm not sure, it's cute still, but it looks a bit off. Next one was something I was really excited for, and it's a bit of a downfall. It's a bit annoying because it's not as good as what I thought it was going to be. So there was these headband things. When I saw them online, I thought it was actually just the headband, and you could just buy the headband straight off, but it's like a DIY packet that doesn't come with glue included. So it just comes with the pom-poms, googly eyes and the headband, and you have to glue the pom-poms on. So you see them pom-poms, they look giant, and then you have different size eyes. Didn't end up being like that. This is what I ended up with. So I made it. I didn't have glue, and then I got glue off my grandma and my granddad. That glue didn't work, so then I ended up just using super glue. And the pom-poms are pretty much all the exact same size. The giant eyes look sort of a bit stupid. So I did have some tiny googly eyes left over from other things that I had. So instead of putting giant ones on them too, I put a teeny tiny one. So I think they look a bit better. But, I mean, it's still sort of cute. But not quite what I envisioned, like, comparison. What the advertisement shows you versus what you get. Although, I think again it has like the eco packaging, because either the two giant googly eyes I didn't use. And it's not plastic, I think it's like paper. I mean, it's got a shine to it, so it might not be fully recyclable or eco-friendly, but still, I'm assuming it's better than just generic plastic. So yeah, that's cute. It's still cute. I'll still wear it. I mean, who wouldn't? Fashionable. And then these two are truly, truly adorable. And I'm going to keep them out, hopefully, if my mum doesn't put them away for like the rest of the year, because they're adorable. So the first one is the groom. So it's like a fully articulating skeleton. See, hello, and a pumpkin head, and he's wearing like a little suit because he's engaged and it's the wedding day, and I just think it's really cute, and you can just sort of sit him on my shoulder. Hello. So I got him, and just sit there, lie there even, and then I got his missus. So here she is, very pretty. You pull her dress a bit forward, showing off a bit of things that you don't want to be showing off there, my dear. So again, she's fully articulating. She's actually a bit more flexible. Might be because like the ball joints there aren't covered. But yeah, they're cute. I don't think the heads turn. No, the heads are fixed, but there's a dangly thing, so you can like dangle them from lights that I have there or wherever, or you can just sort of sit them. So yeah, that is everything that we ended up getting from Sainsbury's. There were quite a lot of other cute things that I would have got, but I can't because I've already got too much stuff. Like, there were really cute lights and like snap bracelets with like plushies on, plushies full stop, which I can't get anymore of, even though there was a really cute giant spider one. And also like a few different like tote bags and stuff, but we already have millions of them. So yeah, there were a lot of costumes as well, nice variation there. And there was a lot of like Disney villain stuff as well, but not that much of a Disney family, Disney villain family, like, you know, like Disney princesses. We like other types of Disney, but not as shown by Nightmare Before Christmas. So yeah, nice variation in Sainsbury's. Maybe like if you have younger kids, like younger siblings, or like if you want to get like a couple of party games to play with your family that you'll have in your house instead of hosting like a big party and getting drunk. There were some nice ones there. So yeah, maybe worth a checking out. I'll keep you informed if I end up getting the Jack Skellington danglers. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I shall be seeing you maybe in another Halloween haul, maybe in something else, I don't really know. So I shall see you, and I hope you have a good October.